members and those of you across this country who have lost loved ones. We're praying for you, and we want you to know that earth has no sorrow that heaven cannot heal. God will be to you just what you allow him to be. On tomorrow, we'll be celebrating the homegoing of Mother Burnside, Maddie Burnside, at Atkins Funeral Home. Viewing will be from 1 to 5, amen. And we will be having a memorial service in August, which will make sure everyone is informed about, amen. We're going to be having a memorial service for our Deacon Ralph Johnson, amen. We'll be letting you know about that, as well as our mother, Malalene Ridgeway. And we're praying for those families, along with the Webster family, and all of those of you across this land and country who might be listening and watching who have lost loved one. For all the sick, amen. God is in the healing business. And we're praying for you, amen. I believe and I know that the prayer of the righteous availeth much. There are many people who've been healed, many people coming out of the hospital. Amen. We're going to be singing that song that Don Vales or Tommy Whitfield, when they said the storm is passing over. Hallelujah. The storm is, my brothers and sisters, is passing over. Amen. And we're giving God a right now, hallelujah. We're going to shout before the battle is over. Amen. To the New Jerusalem family, right after we have finished, and to anyone who would like, right after we would have finished this message today, we're going outside in front of the church on Finkel side. 17330 is the address to our church. We're two blocks east of the Southfield Expressway right here on Finkel. And at the 11:30 to the 1 o'clock hour, we will be giving communion, drive-by communion. All you have to do is come by, drive by. We will serve you communion in your car. You can have your mask on. We're practicing social distancing. But we are not going to let a first Sunday go by that we do not give communion, serve communion to anyone who desires to have it. So you don't have to be a member of this church. We've been serving the bus drivers who come by, who want a communion. We'll serve you. All you have to do is just come on by on the Finkel side of the church at the 11:30 hour, and we'll be glad to serve you communion. Amen. That's today, 11:30 to 1 o'clock this afternoon. Amen. In New Jerusalem, you can bring your tithes and your offerings and drop them off. If not, you know, you can do the Cash App, $ New Jerusalem, or Giverfly. And you can mail them 17330 Finkel, 48227 Detroit, Michigan, New Jerusalem Temple Missionary Baptist Church. You can now bring your offering and drop it off in the mailbox. We got one that's secure now, so you don't have to worry about dropping your mail and your offering off, your tithes and offering in the mailbox. Thank you for all you've been doing to make sure you support this ministry. We have a short word for you today on this first Sunday. If you would look with me for a few minutes at the book of Hebrew, chapter 12, the first and the second verses. Hebrew, chapter 12, verses 1 and 2. And it reads, "Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every way, and the sin which so easily ensnares us, and let us run with endurance the race that is set before us, looking unto Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith, who for the joy that was set before him endured the cross, despising the shame, and has sat down at the right hand of the throne of God.
Yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Therefore, we also, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every heavy weight.
Yes.
I want to talk for a few minutes this morning about lose some weight. Lose some weight.
Yes,
there are many of us that must admit that we have, my brothers and sisters, weight problem.
Yes, Lord.
Overweight. That means that we are above a weight that is considered to be normal or desirable for our height, our age, or our personal preference. Now, I know that we love to use other terms like pleasingly plump and full figure or well-rounded. But being overweight, my brothers and sisters, can be detrimental to our health. Now, family history, we can't change. Genetics, We can't change.
Yeah.
DNA issues we inherit, but lifestyle routines are flexible and fixable. Yes, my brothers and sisters, we need to recognize that we live in a video age. The age of PlayStation and Xbox and Nintendo and remote controls. Yeah. With a push of a button, we can talk to the TV and tell it to change channels. Yeah. With the push of a button, we can play video basketball, video football, video basketball. We can entertain ourselves with that blood splattering gaming. It seems to me like gone are the days when we had to come in before the street lights came on. Nowadays, our young people won't even leave the house. They won't get off the couch. They won't get out of the bed. They wake up, roll over, and grab the video game control or their cell phone. Yeah, I wonder. I don't know about you, but I began to wonder, what are we becoming? Big Macs and Whoppers and banana splits and cheese steaks sandwiches and pizzas and hoggies and ribs and sugar saturated cereals, not to mention the big gulp drinks and the candy and the cookie and the nachos with plenty of cheese and meat. It's no wonder, my brothers and sisters, that our kids are bigger than normal. Dialysis centers are opening up everywhere across the land. Too many donuts, too much beer, too few sit-ups, and too much inactivity. I come today for a few minutes to say that there is a health epidemic in the land.
Yeah.
There is a weight problem that's in our land. And the remedy is today, we need to lose some weight. The remedy is we need, my brothers and sisters, to change our habits. We need to adjust our lifestyle. We need to unload ourselves of all the things that create an unhealthy prognosis for us. And the problem, my brothers and sisters, of weight in the physical is also a problem of consideration in the spiritual. And I'm going to share it with you, and I'm going to let you go. You see, spiritually, my brothers and sisters, the way I see it, spiritually, too many of us are weighed down with things or with people that are holding us down, and things and people that are preventing us, yes, from moving forward in kingdom progress. Yeah, the general definition of weight is anything that blocks our progress. Now in the Greek term for weight, ogos, is a burden or a hindrance. Yeah, it's anything or anybody that delays or deters us. It's anything or anybody that generates difficulties or inhibits us. Yeah. Now, spiritually, some of us have a weight problem because we're hanging with the wrong pride. Yeah, spiritually. I said spiritually, because the Bible says in Corinthians 15, 1 Corinthians 15, 33, said bad company corrupts good character. And then Proverbs 13, 20 says, when you walk with the wise, you become wise. But when you associate yourself with fools, you get in trouble. Oh, yeah. Spiritually, too many of us are lagging behind. Yeah, because we're bogged down with too much worldly weight. I wish you'd pray with me for just a few more minutes. You see, I found that too much alcohol consumption creates a weight problem. Too much indulgence in the drugs creates a spiritual weight problem. Loose lips, yeah, and loose life, and unwillingness to forgive others creates a spiritual weight problem. The love, my brothers and sisters, of money, friendships with this world creates a spiritual weight problem. Being mean and being low down and being angry and stingy and ungenerous creates a spiritual weight problem. Being unloving and unkind and being apathetic and unsympathetic is a spiritual weight problem. Yes, and I'll write up in this text. He says, lay aside every weight and sin which so easily ensnares us. Ensnare means caught in a trap. Ensnare means to be entangled in something that's difficult to escape from. I said difficult, not impossible, but difficult to escape from. And some of us, some of us are caught up and entangled with things or people that's pulling us away from God, that's draining us of the excitement that we once had for God. as well as the love that we have for Jesus and giving him praise and coming and serving him. Some of us are entangled. It's draining us. And the love we once had, the excitement we once had, we don't have anymore because we have a weight problem. I said a weight, it's really a weight problem. Oh yeah, because see, if your joy is gone, it's a weight problem. If your zeal has diminished, it's a weight problem. If you have started to be sporadic in your attendance in church, it's a weight. If your church money was getting funny, it's a weight problem. And it's because we're ensnared, we're caught in a trap. And let me say this, and I'm gonna close. We've been hoodwinked by Satan. Yeah, we've been deluded by his fantasies. We've been set up to be taken down. You see, the devil baits us with temptations and worldly excitements. He allures us with a whole lot of invitation. Y'all know what I'm talking about. Come on to the Mardi Gras. Come on, get your beads and get your booze. Come on, let's go to Las Vegas. Let's go to Las Vegas. Let's win some cash and explore some wild things that you don't have to worry about, because you know what happens in Vegas. Stays in the, come on, the South Beach. Let's have some skippy fun under the sun. Come on, come go with me to Rio de Janeiro, so that we can party all night long. Come on to happy hour. Come on to the freak facts. Come on, go with me to the gentleman's club and make it rain with your mortgage money and your rent money. Come on. Let's have an affair. Let's have a mariage. Yeah, let's swap mates. Let's mix it up. Come on, it's your thing. You can do what you want to do. Come on. You see, the devil cloaks sin, my brothers and sisters, with bright lights. He conceals immorality with legal laws. The devil camouflages corruption with loopholes. That's why Jesus said he comes to steal, to kill, and to destroy. I come to tell you, it's a trap. I said it's a trap. It's a ploy to slow you down. It's a diversionary tactic. It's a weight that none of us need to have. We're, my brothers and sisters, in our clothes. We're in a race. I said we're in a race. And the race that we're in is a spiritual race. It's a race of faith. It's a race of conviction. It's a race of faithfulness. A race of fidelity is a race, my brothers and sisters, of allegiance to God. The writer in Hebrews says, lay aside every weight. In other words, put it down. Give it up. Take it off. In other words, leave it behind. If it hinders you, put it down. If it blurs your spiritual vision, give it up. If it cripples your spiritual walk, take it off. If it interferes with your spiritual commitment, leave it. Hallelujah. Leave it behind. I said, leave him behind. Leave her behind. Leave them behind. Leave all things behind that takes your focus off of God. I heard Jesus say, anyone who puts a hand to the plow and then looks back is not fit for the kingdom of God. In other words, my brothers and sisters, runners who want to win, don't look back. I said, runners who want to win, stay fixated on the goal of the race. The people that's on the sidelines, they don't pay or get distracted by them. Runners who won't win, yes, they condition themselves to win. They watch what they eat. They discipline their bodies. They give themselves a curfew. Matter of fact, they study the rule book. Have I got a witness? And I come to tell somebody who may not know that our rule book is the Bible. Yes, Lord, and it helps us with our weight problems. Yes, I heard the psalmist say, thy word I have hid in my heart that I may not sin against thee. Have I got a witness? Yes, Lord, in order to lose some weight and maintain spiritual fitness, we need the word of God. Yes, Lord, I wish, I hope, if there's somebody screaming at us, you got somebody in the room, if you can just FaceTime when you get through, or call somebody, and just be honest, and tell them, I have a weight problem. Do you hear me? I gotta stop doing something. I got to let some people go. I got to turn my life around. Because I'm lagging in the race. And I got to lose some weight. I wish I had some help. Yes, I gotta lose it. If I wanna cross the finishing line, I gotta lose it. If I wanna hear the Lord say, well done, I gotta lose it. If I wanna please the Lord, and do his will, I gotta lose it, y'all. If I wanna be like Jesus, do you hear me? I heard the writer in the text say, lay aside every weight and sin that ensnares us, and let us run with endurance this race that is before us, looking unto Jesus, hallelujah, who is the author and the finisher of our faith. Have I got a witness? I'm gonna leave you here now, but I want to invite somebody to come on and run with me. Let's run the race. Let's lose some weight. Let's keep our eyes on the prize.
Let's stay focused on the finishing line. Jesus did it, and so can we. I said, Jesus did it, and so should we. He was lied on, but he kept the weight off. He was talked about, but he kept the weight off. He was put to shame, but he kept the weight off. Yeah, he endured. He endured the cross. And I got a witness. He died on Friday. In a weary land, my shelter, my bridge, my walking cane, my friend, Jesus, my shoulder to lean on. His name is above all names. You gotta lose some weight. If heaven is where you wanna go, you gotta lose some weight. All I'm trying to tell somebody, change your diet. Do God's word. Lose some weight, come out from among them. Lose some weight, let your body be a living sacrifice. Lose some weight, be holy like he's holy. Lose some weight, if any man be in Christ Jesus, he is a new creature. Lose some weight, and old things will pass away, and all things shall become new. If you run this race called faith, you gotta walk a new walk. You gotta talk a new talk. Your thoughts got to become new. The way you live got to glorify God. I come to tell you, there's a cloud of witnesses that's cheering for us while we're running. Hebrew 11 said, yeah, Abraham and Isaac, they knowing all them troubles, cheering us on. And I got a witness. The reason they made it is because they lost some weight and finally did what God said do. Lose some weight, it'll make you look better. Lose some weight, it'll make you feel better. Lose some weight, yeah, you'll be able to move better. God bless you. If you don't hear me again, I just came to tell somebody who would pay attention to the word. Lose some weight. The saints of old are depending on you. Jesus is depending on you. Your mama, your daddy,
But I'm gonna lose some weight. But I wanna hear my Savior say, servants of God, you've been faithful over a few things, but come on up. I'm gonna make you ruler. Well done. Well done. Oh, well done. That good. That good and faithful servant. We gotta lose some weight. We gotta let some stuff go. Gotta let some people go. Gotta let some habits go. Lose the weight and run the weight race with patience, keeping your eyes on the prize. And you know what the prize is. Prize is the author and the finisher of our faith, Jesus Christ. It's because he lives, that we even have a chance to be in the race in the first place. So stop getting fat. Stop getting spiritually fat. Lose weight. Let it go. Take it off. Lay it aside. Because heaven should be our goal. I'm talking about each and every day. We ain't living to die. We're living to live. If you want to live on the other side, gotta lose some weight. Lord, we love you. And we bless your name. Lord, we thank you for giving us this exercise. Better than the exercise I get. This exercise is fitting me for the kingdom. And I want to be ready. When you call my name. And I pray that somebody that's watching, someone who's listening, that may not like being called fat, but recognize they're spiritually overweight and that something needs to be done. They want to know what to do and say they got no trainer. It's a lie, because they do. We got your word. Everything we need, every instruction is in the word of God. So I pray today, oh God, that some of us start right now to taking it up, throwing it away, laying it aside, and staying focused on running the race. Because we know in the end, if we do it your way, can't no viruses or anything stop us. In the end, we're gonna win. Because the race is not given to the swift nor the strong, but to the one who loses weight and endures unto the end. Bless your people. Heal your people. Save your people. Deliver your people. There's someone who's watching and listening. They need to know you're in a part of their sins. Let them simply confess with their mouth that they believe in you, that you died and you got up from the grave, coming back again. Them confess they can do that with you yourselves right now. In the name of Jesus. And I I shall be saved. We love you, Lord, and we bless your name. We pray your blessings upon this land, upon your country. We ask it all in Jesus' name and for his sake, thank God. Amen. God bless you. God's will. We'll see you again on the stream on Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday of this week. And in another 35 minutes, we'll be outside on Finkel and Oakfield, 17330 Finkel, corner of Oakfield, two blocks east of Southfield. Give a drive-by communion. If you'd like to have communion on this first Sunday, just come on by. We'll be happy to serve you. Keep us in your prayers, and we certainly will keep you in ours. God bless you.